good morning to you and you. Good morning. This is Miss S. We are here at 92.9 FM. This is Choice Radio. And you are going to get praises unto the Lord as you just enjoyed with Pastor Atwell. But before we continue, let us have our dear sister Jasmine say our prayer of thanksgiving or of repentance.
Brought to you by Ministries Without Boundaries. As you already know, that prayer is not only meant to solve problems. Prayer is a contact point to get you connected with God. Prayer is a form of communication between you and God. Prayer brings unique relationship that no money can buy. Prayer is a forum for parents and children. It also sends off an aroma and aromatic expression that produces sweet smelling incense. Get involved in prayer now. Turn your homes or your cars into a prayer station, a house of praise and worship center, not an arena for pain and sorrow. There are different ways to pray, different types of prayer, and different times to pray. There are times when you will pray long prayers and time when you pray short prayers, but we need to pray effective prayers. And in order for us to pray effective prayers, we have to pray God's words back to Him. So for that reason, we have to study the Word of God, which is the Bible, and then we pray the Word of God back to Him. All right? So first thing you want to do when you get into prayer, whether you're by yourself at home, in your car, or in church as a group, the first thing you want to do is to confess your sins. Confess who God is. Ask God for forgiveness. So today, we will start with repentance prayer. And each prayer you do, you want to ask God to forgive you, whether you're praying for someone or praying for yourself. Ready? Let's pray. This prayer is a thanksgiving prayer. Just giving God thanks for all that He has done, all that He's doing, and all that He's about to do. So let's give God thanks.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. I thank you, Lord. Yeah.
Hallelujah. As the world. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I just want to give you thanks. I just want to give you praise. I just want to adore you. I just want to magnify your name. Lord, I want to thank you for your love, your grace, and your mercy. Thank you for your mercy that is brand new every morning. Thank you, God, for your compassion that faileth not. Thank you, God, for hearing and answering my prayers. Thank you, God, for deliverance. Thank you for delivering me out of the lion's den. Thank you, God, for delivering me out of the fiery furnace. Thank you, God, for delivering me from the prison of bondage. Thank you, God, for deliverance from everything that held me hostage. Thank you, God, for deliverance, oh God, from that which held me captive against my will. Thank you, Lord, for delivering me, oh God, and delivering my marriage from every satanic assignment, wicked counsel, traps, witchcraft, caging, misery, confusion, resentment, divorce, separation from every evil words, Lord God, that has ever spoken against me, my husband, my marriage, my family. Lord, I just want to say thank you, God, for health and strength. Thank you, God, for the roof over my head. Thank you, God, for food on my table. Thank you for clothes on my back. Lord, I want to thank you for more than enough. Thank you, God, that I may extend to others. Thank you, God, for salvation. Thank you, God, for the ministries you have entrusted me with. Thank you, God, for saving my children. Thank you, God, for saving my loved ones. Thank you, God, for removing hardness of heart, oh God. Thank you for removing stubbornness, disobedience, ungratefulness, selfishness, unwillingness, judgmental spirit. Thank you, God, for removing the spirit of unforgiveness. Thank you, God, for delivering me from the valley of the shadow of death. Thank you, God, for drawing me out of many deep waters. Thank you, God, for delivering me from my strong enemies. Thank you, God, for your power that allows me to run through troops and leap over walls. Thank you, God, for teaching my hands to war, that bows of steel will be broken by my own arm. Thank you, God, for giving me hind feet, that whatever I step on will be destroyed forever. Thank you, God, for girding my loins with power, anointing, and strength. Thank you, God, oh God, that I was able to pursue my enemy and overtake them. Thank you, Lord, for delivering my enemies into my hands. Thank you, God, for giving me a choice to beat them small as dust and scatter them out in the street, or to pray for their soul to be saved. Thank you, Lord, for sending your arrows to frustrate those that gather against me to seek my death and destruction, oh God, and to see my downfall. Thank you, Lord, for lifting me high above them, oh God, that's trying to wound me and capture my spirit. Father God, I just want to thank you. Thank you, Lord, for lighting my candle in this world of darkness. Thank you, God, for recompensing me, oh God, with good because of the pureness of my heart. Oh God, the righteousness of my heart, the cleanness of my hand. Oh God, and because I have shown mercy to others. Thank you for peace of mind. Thank you, God, for enlarging my border, widening my territory, and extending my step. Thank you, Lord God, that I may not slip. Thank you for the mobility of my limbs. Thank you, Lord, that you will allow people whom I don't know to serve me. Thank you, God, oh God, that my enemy will submit themselves to me. Thank you, God. I just want to thank you, Lord, for every woman, every man, oh God, of true living almighty God, of this creation of heaven and earth. Lord God, that you have placed me on their hearts to pray for me, intercede for me, fast for me, stand in the gap for me, hold me up, oh God, and strengthen me, especially my mother, God. Extraordinary strength for her in Jesus' name. Lord, whatever I fail to thank you for, Lord God, Lord, by name, Lord, you know. Lord, I pray that you will not fail, oh God, to know that I appreciate you, and I'm thankful, and I am grateful. Lord, I thank you in Jesus' name for everything that you have done, about to do, and still doing in my life. Lord, I say thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen and amen.
And we say amen and amen. Praise the Lord. We just want to thank our God today, because he says to enter into his gates with thanksgiving. And of course, we've done just that. And you know that your life is a life of thanksgiving and prayer. I just wanted you to be reminded that prayer and the praises, they all go together. And so here I am on Choice Radio. You know who I am. This is Miss S, bringing you victory in praise. And of course, we've got the victory. We've got the victory. The moment our eyes were opened this morning and we said, thank you, Lord, and we give him praise. So here's our brother Bigger to praise our God with us.
Face tomorrow because he lives. All my fear is gone because I know. He lives. confess tomorrow, because he lives, all my fear is gone, because I know. Touching Jesus is all that matters, and your life will never be the same. No, no, there is only one way. I said to touch him, all you gotta do is believe. When you call on his name, oh, touching Jesus is all that matters. Be the same. No, no, there is only one way. I said to touch him, all you gotta do is believe. When you call his name, coming home, oh Lord, I'm coming home. Never more to roam. Oh Lord, I said, open wide thine arms of love. Lord, I am coming home. Precious Lord, take my hands, lead me home, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Whoa, through the storm, through the night, Lord, lead me home to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When my life goes drift, precious Lord lingers near. When my life is almost gone, oh, hear my cry, hear my call, hold my hand, lest I fall. gracious Lord, I am coming home. Said I, fly away, oh glory, and I fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away.
Oh, indeed, indeed, indeed. We're going to fly away with our dear brother Brigger. Oh, that was so good. God bless him. God bless you out there. And as you continue to bless our Lord with me, I will lift up his name and give him praise. And of course, we must remember that the Holy Ghost fire is with us.
Holy Ghost power moving just like a magnet.
Oh, indeed, the Holy Ghost power is moving just like a magnet. I hope he's moving in your heart. I hope right now, right this moment, he is moving in your heart. And as he moves, you know that you can praise him. You can lift up his name. You can, oh, turn to someone and say, let us praise the Lord together and let us rejoice in our salvation. For that's what we should do and that's what we're doing. We just thank God for the power, and the power is the Holy Ghost. And having given us his power, we will continue as Paul wrote to the Romans of their responsibility as a Christian. And he wrote it in Romans chapter 12, and we can read that so that we get an understanding as to what the Holy Ghost wants us to do, what he wants of us as Christians. We talk of being a Christian, we talk of loving, we talk of sharing, and yet there are times when we fall very, very short. So let's read this again. Here's what Paul says. Therefore, I urge you, brothers, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as living sacrifices, holy and pleasing to God. This is your spiritual act of worship. Do not conform any longer to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, his good, pleasing, and perfect will. For by the grace given me, I say to every one of you, do not think of yourself more highly than you ought, but rather think of yourself with sober judgment in accordance with the measure of faith God has given you. Just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not all have the same function, so in Christ, we who are many form one body. And each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts according to the grace given us. If a man's gift is prophesying, let him use it in proportion to his faith. If it is serving, let him serve. If it is teaching, let him teach. If it is encouraging, let him encourage. If it is contributing to the needs of others, let him give generously. If it is leadership, let him govern diligently. If it is showing mercy, let him do it cheerfully. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil. Cling to what is good. Be devoted to one another in brotherly love. Honor one another above ourselves and above yourselves. Never be lacking in zeal, but keep your spiritual fervor serving the Lord. Be joyful in hope, patient in affliction, faithful in prayer. Share with God's people who are in need. Practice hospitality. Bless those who persecute you. Bless and do not curse. Rejoice with those who rejoice. Mourn with those who mourn. Live in harmony with one another. Do not be proud, but be willing to associate with people of low position. Do not be conceited. Do not repay another evil for evil. Be careful to do what is right in the eyes of everybody. It is possible, and if it is possible, as far as it depends on you, live at peace with everyone. Do not take revenge, my friends, but leave room for God's wrath. For it is written, it is mine to avenge. I will repay, says the Lord. On the contrary, if your enemy is hungry, feed him. If he is thirsty, give him something to drink. In doing this, you will keep burning coals on his head. So, do not overcome evil, but overcome evil with good. This is the word of the Lord God unto you. As Paul, who was moved by the Holy Spirit to write it, wrote it to the Romans. And he wrote it to the Romans then, and he's writing it to you and I today. And so we must continue to be responsible for the grace that God has placed in and on your lives. And especially as the Holy Ghost moves upon us to do his will. Brothers and sisters, listeners out there, today is the day when we need to surrender all to God, to give him all. As Paul says, to sacrifice yourself. He did not mean that you should get upon a iron board and be cut in pieces. He wants your flesh to be cut, to be sobering, to think soberly, and to trust God to work his will in you. This is something very, very urgent today. As we hear such evil news that are coming through, even from the church, even from the body of Christ, even in our own selves, as we examine ourselves, we do have things to repent of and to call on God to change our hearts and to have his way in us. Are we wondering why we are not being well? Why we are not doing well? Why we are not prospering? I don't know if you have to do to get, but certainly when your ways please God, he lets everyone and everything work together for your good. So trust in God. Hold on to him. Lift up your hearts unto him. And one of the things that we ought to do more often than we do is praise our God. And so here I am to lift his name up.
Jesus is alive and well. Jesus is alive and well. Tell
believe that. Jesus is alive. And the song sings, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, lift up those praises because he is alive. He told John in the Revelations that I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. Oh, give him praise. You know not what hour, you know not what moment he's going to arrive. So you must lift him up and praise him. For you don't know what time he's going to be here. So when he comes, let him find you praising him, singing hallelujah. For where can you go? Where are you going to go but to our Lord Jesus Christ? Lift him up as our own brother does. Here he sings, where can I go?
Living below in this so simple world, hardly a comfort can afford. Striving along to face temptation, so where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Gain a refuge for my soul, needing a friend to save me in the end. Where could I go but to the life here is grand with friends I love so dear. Comfort I get from God's own word. Yet when I feel that chilling hand of death, where could I go but to the Lord? Where could I go? Oh, where could I go? Seeking a refuge for my soul, needing a friend save me in the end. Where could I go but to the Lord? Somebody tell me, where could I go but to the Lord?
Oh, we just want to praise our God. We just want to give him thanks and praise him. For he is so good to us, isn't he? Yes, he is. And that was our own Donnie Brown. I pray that he heard his song today. That was for you again, Donnie. That was a beautiful song that you played. Oh, I trust that you heard it. And may the Lord continue to bless you. Please give me a call. Let's know how you're doing. I trust that you're doing well. All right, God bless you. And so here's another song as we continue to praise our God.
Yeah.
Ooh, hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah to the Lord our God. I love when we praise the Lord and lift up his holy name and just want to do it and want to. You can feel it coming out of your being. So I'm preparing you to get into your congregation today and lift up Jesus. Praise him. Be the loudest voice in the church. Be the loudest voice out there and shout your praises as you praise the Lord today. God is amazingly wonderful. He just wants us to love him. He wants us to show forth his love to the world. And don't be ashamed, because you don't have anything to be ashamed of. I know the enemy puts it into your mind. Oh, what is he going to think of you? What is she going to say? Look what you say. Oh, say, devil, under my feet, and stomp real hard on him by shouting the glories of the Lord. For the Lord our God is worthy. He is God. There is none other. There is no other God but the God of Jeshurun, who rides upon the heaven in our help and in his excellency in the skies. Look up to him. Trust in him. Wait on him. Oh, he's ever, 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 ever so good. Isn't he good to you? Yes, he is. Oh, I thank God for him. You're listening to Choice Radio. It is your salvation. We hope you make that choice. Make the choice for Jesus Christ. That's it. Just make that choice. Oh, I thank my brother Kelvin for calling. Mr. Hodge, I hope your family is doing well. I hope the baby is growing really, really well. I'm sure they all are. Give my blessings, and I continue to pray for you and the family. And I thank God that you are able to give me a call today. I trust in God for you. All right? I trust that he would give you that job that you are looking for and need. And God is faithful, Kelvin. Stay with him. Stay with the Lord, for he will never leave you. And you know what? He'll never forsake you.
With you, call Jesus. Can I walk with you? Call Jesus. Can I walk with you? Call Jesus. Can I talk with you?
Can I talk with you?
Call Jesus. Can I talk with you?
Can I
Jesus. Oh, yes. Jesus, can I walk with you? Can I talk with you? Can you? Oh, yes, indeed. Yes, indeed. You can walk, you can talk, you can dance, you can laugh, you can sleep with Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the Lord. Yes, I'm in that space today, loving the Lord with all my heart, as much as I can. Oh, the Lord, my God, is so loving and so lovable. He is ever, ever, ever so lovely. And when you think on him, you just give the praise and the glory and the honor and the peace and the joy and all that comes with it. All of that is your salvation. God did not just save you out of the mess that you were in. He rejoiced over you. He lifts you up. He cleans you up. He washes you. And you know what? He does it daily. He keeps right on. His word is there to wash you daily. And you just have to keep right on doing it. Just keep right on opening up to him. Oh, just love the Lord and give him the glory. Give him the praise. Rejoice evermore in him. For you know, he is so worthy. Isn't he? Come on, you just say it. Say, Lord, you are worthy to be praised indeed. I will praise you.
Let the earth hear his voice. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice.
Jesus, I pray.
Worthy to be praised, and indeed we thank him every minute. For we know not what the enemy plans, but God knows. And if we keep on trusting in God and thanking him, we just have to wait on him and he will take care of us. I know in Psalm 61 it says that in the time when I am afraid, I will look to the Lord, I will call upon him. Here it is. Hear my cry, O God. Listen to my prayer. From the ends of the earth, I can call to you. I call as my heart grows faint. Lead me to the rock that is higher than I. For you have been my refuge, a strong tower against the enemy. I long to dwell in your tent forever, and take refuge in the shelter of your wings. For you have heard my vows, O God. You have given me the heritage of those who fear your name. Increase the days of the king's life, his years for many, many generations. May he be enthroned in God's presence forever. Appoint your love and faithfulness to protect him. Then will I ever sing praise to your name and fulfill my vows day after day. Oh, day after day. In fact, we add moment after moment, hour after hour. In the very instant of your breathing, you give praise and thanks to God. For the enemy attacks at any time, at any place, no matter what you're doing, no matter what you're saying, and he will come and destroy you if he could. But listen, you continue to give praises unto the Lord. You continue to call upon his name. You who know who Jesus is, you don't have to go far. Just breathe his name out loud. Breathe his name out calmly. Breathe his name out quietly, and the enemy will flee. He will flee from you. So trust God and lift up his name in songs and praise, in psalms and in glorious, wondrous thoughts of him. All right? Let's just continue. The Lord is so good. I hope you did not forget to turn your clock back and that you're not in church for 11 o'clock when it's 10 o'clock, or in church for 8 o'clock when it's 9 o'clock. All right? I trust that you did what you know you're supposed to do. All right, then keep all things in condition, on the subjection, of course, to our Lord. Oh, just let us sing unto him.
Oh,
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. With all of my heart, I'm going to praise him. He is all of that. He is much more. And he has me, and I want to be in the center of his will, in his perfect will. Oh, he is so worthy to be praised when he has me right there, right there. And he has you too, because the Lord God has the world in his hands. You cannot escape from him. If you don't trust him and don't lift up his name and call upon him to save you from this untoward generation, from the wrath to come, oh, God is not going to prevent you from not doing that. But listen, he wants you to. He has given you a will that you make the choice to come unto him. Make that choice. Make it today. Make it right now. Say, Jesus, Jesus, my Savior, he is your Lord. When he stopped Saul on the road to Damascus, when Saul recognized that this was Jesus whom he was destroying, he said, Lord, Lord, what will you have me to do? You are sitting and listening and hearing. Ask him, what will he have you to do? Because there is something that he has you to do. God has allowed you to come into this world so that you can make that choice for him. God wants you. He loves you. In fact, I could say he needs you because he wants to give you all that he can give to you. Oh, he needs you to do that so that he can give you all the blessings, all the joys, everything that his son is to him. He wants to do that to you. And I think that you should take advantage of it. Take a hold of it. Oh, this is one time when it's not bad to take advantage of something. This is the time. You want to take advantage of someone or something? Take advantage of Jesus. Hold on to him. Grab a hold of him and don't let him go. He'll never let you go. So you don't let him go. Oh, just hold on to him. Try it. Try it. Reach out and touch him.
Living in this temple, dealing with this clay, I've been known to compromise. You have seen me turn away. Though I've been distracted by temporary thrills, yet I could never live outside the center of your will. Resolutions broken, their promises unbroken. You have held my faithless heart like a father while you wept. I've been on the edge before, and I have felt the chill. Yet I can never live outside the center to the throne. I'm following. yet I could never live outside the center of your will. No, I could never live outside the center of your will. No,
be in the center of his will. To be in the center of his will. Oh, stand firm and stand strong, for he's holding you up and he is all powerful. The Almighty God, the omnipotent, omniscient, omnipresent God. He is sovereign and he is all in all. The Most High God. He is God over all. Trust him. Why not? Trust him. Oh, won't you trust him? Huh? I know I will. He has made this whole world. He has kept it for all these millenniums. He has put all good things in it. He has made the birds to fly. He has made the air we breathe so we can stay alive. Oh yes, I trust this God. He is God and there is none other. Be in the center of his will. Oh, no matter what happens, no matter where you go and who you're with, know that God is the center of your being. Whatever you say, whatever you do, however you are saying it, in the midst of you is God. Let no one shake you. Let no one startle you. Let no one think little of you. Even if they do think little of you, you know the big God that is inside you. And you know, you can laugh at that storm. You can laugh at the decree. You can just laugh inside and know that God, the Eternal One, is with you and for you. And he will never leave you. He will never forsake you. You're listening to Choice Radio. Remember to keep it locked right there, 92.9 FM. For you must make the choice for your salvation and for your life. And if you keep it locked right here at Choice Radio, 92.9 FM, you will get a chance to make that choice. Believe me, and you will never, never, never be ashamed of having done so. I just want to shout out to a young man I met yesterday. He literally accosted me in the street, and I pray that he's listening. His name is, and I'll let you know, Michael Prince. I meant he's someone who has a mission for God. He says he has a mission, and he does. He has a mission for God that God gave for him. And he is making sure that as many as he can talk to know about it. He just met me and he came up to me and he says, you want a record? He has a CD. Oh, what a blessing he is. If you're listening to me, Michael Prince, you are a prince. God has made you a prince. I love what you say in your CD and I'll read it out. It says, my mission. Blessed be the God and Father of my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who has given me the talent to sing. Praise and glory to his name, using music to spread the good news all over the world. That's my mission. All praise to God. And you know, I was just so excited because he sat and stayed right there in the street and played me this song.
The reason why I'm singing, God has done something, something for me. He set me free. I'm standing strong. God hold my hands. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I cannot keep it from my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. So I'll make some music now and sing a song. By the power of the Spirit, I will spread the word around. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I know it's a jungle out there, but God is everywhere. I don't have to be afraid to spread the word around. I cannot keep it for my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. So I'll put on my backpack with my CDs, grab my stereo and go, go, go. Well, this is my calling. This is my gift. This is my talent, and I really love to do it. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I cannot keep it for my own self. To tell someone that Jesus is the one.
You see how blessed our Lord is, how wonderful our Lord is. The Lord is blessed always, and He just blesses us. Oh, my dear sister Pat, God bless you. God bless you. God bless you for calling. And I thank you for loving that song. I had no idea that other people would have heard of it, but I am happy to have let it out here in the airways so others can hear it. It is such a beautiful song. And you know, the brother has a telephone number. I didn't tell him that I would do this, but I'm just led to do it. I'm going to give you his telephone number because it's on the CD, so it is public. It's 718-974-5967. And if you would like a copy of this music, please call him, Brother Michael Prince. Isn't that a beautiful name? Michael Prince, 718-974-5967. 5967, and please, oh, get his CD. It is so pretty to hear someone picking up Jesus, having a mission like that. God is going to bless him, and I ask the Lord to bless you mightily, Michael, as you spread the gospel around in your music and song. And so, Sister Pat, I'm going to play this for you from the top again. Here it is.
The reason why I'm singing, God has done something, something for me. He set me free. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I cannot keep it from my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. So I'll make some music now and sing a song. By the power of the Spirit, I will spread the word around. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I know it's a jungle out there, but God is everywhere. I don't have to be afraid to spread the word around. I cannot keep it for my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. So I'll put on my backpack with my CDs, grab my stereo and go, go, go. Well, this is my calling. This is my gift. This is my talent, and I really love to do it. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I cannot keep it for my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. Why I'm singing, God has done something, something for me. He set me free. So I'll make some music now and sing a song. By the power of the Spirit, I will spread the word around. I know it's a jungle out there, but God is everywhere. I don't have to be afraid to spread the word around. I cannot keep it for my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. So I'll put on my backpack with my CDs, grab my stereo and go, go, go. Well, this is my calling. This is my gift. This is my talent, and I really love to do it. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I cannot keep it from my own self. I have to tell someone that Jesus is the one. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil. I'm standing strong. God hold my hand. I'm safe and secure from the devil.
Oh, isn't that wonderful? That's such a beautiful testimony. Oh, I need you, brothers and sisters out there who know how to pray for this young man who loves the Lord so much. And he's out there on the street with his CD telling the message, testifying of the love of God. Yes, he's standing strong in the will of God and doing God's will. Isn't that wonderful? And that's what it's all about, being a Christian, to tell about Jesus, to meet someone. You never know who you're going to talk with. You never know who you're going to speak to. You never, never know. And God wants you to tell about him, speak about him, open your mouth. You don't have to have proper language, nice diction and beautiful phrases. No, just say, Jesus loves you, girl. Jesus loves you, guy. Come on, let's talk about him. And you know, watch what God will do. He will open you up and he will blow his love up in you so that all can see it and receive it. Oh, and live a life for him. And that's what you want to do. All right, so let God speak to your heart. Let him speak to the love in your heart and pray for our brother Michael Prince. Don't forget.
Your spirit, God, and let your word above
speak to my heart, Lord.
Yeah, Lord, yeah.
Be holy,
yeah, Lord.
I can't hear from you.
Yeah, Jesus.
Then I know what to do.
And then I know
I
what
won't
to do.
Go alone.
Oh,
I'll never go on my own.
No,
just let your spirit,
God, guide me, Jesus.
And let your word above.
Oh.
Speak to our hearts, O God. Speak to our hearts, O God. O God, let us have ears to hear when you're speaking to us, that we may listen. Speak to us, O God. Speak to our hearts. Let it burst with your sound. Lord, O God, speak to our hearts. And let us be willing, Father, to hear and to listen and to do. Even as we are told, speak to us, Lord. Please speak to us. Let us go on trusting you and walking with you. Speak to our hearts, O God. We read in Acts 28 and verse 23, where Paul went to this island. And hear what he says. They arranged to meet Paul on a certain day and came in even larger numbers to the place where he was staying. From morning till evening, he explained and declared to them the kingdom of God and tried to convince them about Jesus from the law of Moses and from the prophets. Some were convinced by what he said, but others would not believe. They disagreed among themselves and began to leave after Peter had made this final statement. The Holy Spirit spoke the truth to your forefathers when he said, through Isaiah the prophet, go to this people and say, this is what Isaiah is saying to the people. Go to these people and say, you will be ever hearing, but not understanding. You will be ever seeing, but never perceiving. For this people's heart has become calloused. They hardly hear with their ears, and they have closed their eyes. Otherwise, they might see with all their eyes and hear with all their ears, understand with their hearts, and turn, and I would heal them. Oh, I tell you, we have got to think, learn, study, proclaim, declare, tell the word of God in season, out of season, when we feel like it and when we don't. Just stand up for the Lord. Let him speak to your heart and proclaim the word of God unto the people, just as Paul did. And he went on, therefore, I want you to know that God's salvation has been sent to the Gentiles, and they will listen. And they will listen. The word of God came to the Gentiles after the Jews refused. And so here is Paul, the apostle, bringing the word to you and to me and to the world out there who did not know him. This time, we need to be taking the word. We are many Pauls out there giving the word, whether they hear or whether they forbear. Give the word. We know not what God is about. We don't have his heart, his note, but we have his word. And he wants all to be saved. He does not want anyone to perish. Please, give the word. Send the word. Tell the word. Be the word. And God will raise you up and be in the center of your being. Trust in him. Trust in him to call out and say that Jesus saves. Here, look what he's done to me. Look what he's done for me. Here I am. Listen. Look up. Look to Jesus. Look to Jesus. The time is drawing so near, where everyone wants to have an itching ear. Everyone has, just about. They want to hear the gaudy things, and they want to hear the philosophies, and they want to hear what you live through. And instead of getting into the word, instead of loving Jesus, instead of calling on to him, oh, get into the word, get into a church, get with people who love the Lord and want to talk about the word of God. so that you know who he is. These are days and times when you haven't got time to waste, and the enemy puts so much stuff in our way that we become so discarded. We are fighting to get through. Why? Because we are not taking the word on by faith and spreading it. Oh, I was just so pleased to meet this young man who wants to talk about the Lord, who wants to love the Lord. I met with Brother Clarence here, right here in the studio, and was so thrilled to find a young man who loves the Lord, who is trusting in the Lord with all his heart, with all his being. He just wants God to be in the center of him, and he to be the center of God's will. Oh, trust God for everything. Look unto him. Brothers and sisters, everyone who know the Lord's will in his word, trust him. Right here on 92.9 FM Choice Radio, we are doing all that God would want us to do, and we are praying that we are doing his will. But as long as we tell of his love, as long as we tell of who God is, who Jesus is, and why he came, and who you are to him, we are doing his will. Walk with us. Talk with us. Be with us. Come on now. You know someone who needs to know the Lord, who needs to be helped. You know someone. Give them our number. We are here on Mondays from 2 p.m. And you can call. Call the number right here, 718-715-4411. Call that number on Mondays and every day from 10 a.m. And someone will be here to listen to you, to encourage you, to bring God's grace closer into your heart. Call this number again, 718-715-4411. You need prayer. You need counseling. You need to be ministered to. You need to be built up some more. We are never, never, never have enough. We need so much more. I know I do. I am thrilled and blessed when I tune in and hear our own Pastor Randolph on this station. Let me tell you, what a man of God. When you let God have his way and his will in you, you can say and do God's will so profoundly. If you were to listen and open your hearts, not as the Jews did, but open your hearts and your understanding, you will hear what God has to say to you. Oh, Pastor Randolph is so good, so clear, so precise. Now he's my teacher. He may not know it, but he is, because he breaks that word down and I get into it, and I'm just so excited when he says, get a paper and get a pen and write. Yes, I do. And so should you. Listen, there's nothing any more important to you than to know who God is, to get the proper understanding of him, and to learn it from someone whom he has entrusted with his word. Oh, stay tuned to 92.9 Choice Radio and get all of the blessings that are out here for you in Christ Jesus. Listen, if you want the boogie boogie, you can go to another station. If you want whatever, somebody's business going on out there, you can go to another station. But I'm telling you, want Jesus. Want Jesus. And if you want Jesus, you will keep it stuck right here on 92.9 FM. Not only will you want to do that, but you will call someone and tell them. Tell them. Oh, come on and hear. Do like the woman at the well. And she went into the village. And she says, come and see a man. Oh, that word, that message, that story in the Bible just so thrills me. I could just see her in my mind going out and shouting out and saying, come and see a man. Oh, he has said he knows everything about me. He has told me everything. Oh, and in my heart, I am so excited. Come and see a man. Oh, that's what we are telling you right here on Choice Radio. Come and meet the Lord Jesus Christ. Take him into your heart. Oh, watch what he will do for you. He will light you up and you will have a mission. You will have no choice because he opens you so that you just want to spill out all this greatness, all this love, this person. Oh, God, our Father, who has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, into the world. Come on now. Come on, get on with it. All right? Oh, let's sing that song again.
Hallelujah. And one song says, who did you call? Wonderful counselor, you say.
Oh, glory, hallelujah.
Yes, sir.
Power, just power. power. Power to live right and to work right and to stay on track right. Lord, I thank you. Thank you for the power. God is amazingly wonderful, isn't he? You know what? Oh, I didn't know the time had gone so quickly. I tell you, and I did not get into my children's scripture today. Ooh, we're in the book of Malachi, remember? We finished with Zechariah, and we were going to finish up on Malachi today. We were going to finish up the Old Testament today and move into the New Testament. Oh, my. I'm telling you, it's going to be exciting. So, we're not going to finish it up today because it's much too late to start now. But keep right on reading the Word of God, boys and girls. Please, read Malachi. In Malachi is where we get the command to pay the tithe and to pay the offering. And so I just don't want to run it through. I want to do it well, just so that you understand. So next Sunday, God's willing, I will come back with the book of Malachi, which is the last book of the Old Testament. And we will study it, and we will try to get as much out of it as we can on next Sunday. Of course, if the Holy Spirit moves us to take it as long as we can, we will. Because we need his power to keep going. We need to be in his will. We need to do what he tells us to do. Today was certainly no accident that we did not read Malachi. Because the Spirit of the Lord just kept doing what he wants to do in me. And I know that. Oh, the Lord is so good. When you can be obedient, when you can hear and listen and do, oh, those are so important things, those three things. Hear, listen, and do. Some people hear and they don't listen. Some people listen and they don't hear. Some people listen and they don't do. Some people hear and they don't do. Some people do and didn't hear, didn't listen. So it's important that you hear, you listen, and you do. That you hear the word of God and go out there and practice it. Practice it. Oh, it's not hard. It's not a chore. It's not a chore. It's not a drudge. It's a joy. It's sweetness. Oh, as Jeremiah says, shut up in your bones. And you just want to just light that fire and let it go ablaze through all the earth. Oh, if that were you, wouldn't you do that? Oh, what a blessing. But God has a plan for your life. God has a good plan for your life. And he is going to see that it comes to pass. Nothing is going to stop it. Whatever the plan is, it will come to pass. Just seek him so you know what the plan of God is for your life. As you grow, know that God loves you and that he has put his Holy Spirit in you. He has breathed his breath of life in you so that you can live for him and tell others of his great love. All right? Here's a song just for you, boys and girls. Here it is.
For all.
To the Son of God, and you can do that right now. You don't have to go to glory to do it. You can do it right now. Just sing, clap your hands, and praise God. Continue to pray one for the other and to be good Christians. Trust in the Lord. I love you, and may God continue to bless you as you continue to leave it right here. Leave it right there on Choice Radio 92.9 FM. Call a friend, and God bless you.
Oh, my, my, yeah, holy manasseh, you make my life so beautiful. How many of you are beautiful today?
You make my life so beautiful, beautiful, so beautiful. And as you are, you have made me beautiful. Thank you, Jesus. There's nothing greater than this. That's why I love you
up your hands wherever you are. You make my life so beautiful.
Glory, glory, glory. I'm just honored to be here today, this morning, in front of you. I just want you all to keep our pastor in prayer. And we are here today to share the word and be together and enjoy the fellowship of sharing the word of God and enjoy it. It's so much that we can share every day. It's just like this place is just like, it's my home. And it's just like, when I come out here, it's just like if I was just, as I just get up, it's just like everything that I'm going to sleep, I'm going here, this is my house. So when I'm around in the house of the Lord, I'm blessed to be here, so I just want to share that blessing with you all. Today we're going to be just touching a little things that we already know. And I would say everything that we talk about here in church and in scriptures, in the Bible, I know everyone read it on a daily basis, and they read maybe read the whole Bible already. So it's not nothing new, but it is something that we expand on, and it says faith come by hearing. So if we continue hearing the word and checking up on ourselves and seeing what we're doing and hearing the word, it will help us a lot to understand and be with Christ, more closer to him in through his word. He said we'll be touching upon a word that is about the assurance of our salvation. So upon it's made and upon the foundation of repentance, God desires that the believers receive assurance of salvation. And many Christians never come to the full fullness of assurance. And the salvation of it is that we should listen to these things. We will go over it and find out where we are and know who we are in Christ. Because God already gave us the word. He acknowledged us. He revealed himself to us. A lot of us already accept Jesus Christ as a Lord and Savior. So we are already there. But it's to maintain where we are, to be know who we are in Christ and where we stand in his word and where we stand in the life of God. So when everyone sees us, they know that we are men of God, a woman of God, because our behavior and our lifestyles is godly. And it's what it is all about. So we try to enjoy those blessings also. I know that God assures us that everlasting life and these things will come to pass. So we can start with Romans chapter 8, verse 32. So everyone just look for that scripture, Romans chapter 8, verse 32. So the assurance is the repentance, the foundation of repentance. God desires the believers to receive assurance of salvation, and many Christians never come to the full assurance of their salvation because of several matters that we'll be going through today and adjusting ourselves in this walk in Christ that we are in today. So we're picking it up at chapter 8 and verse 32, and it says, amen? It says, he that spared not his own son, but deliver him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Quite an information here is telling us that God spared his son. He gave his son for our sin. And if he did that, and he will give us all things. It says that he will not leave anything out. Now, it's like assurance that anything that we want or we desire of our heart, as long as it's in the will of our Father, is ours. But a lot of us sometimes acknowledge that, and we don't acknowledge that we are the children of God. We don't walk, we don't live, and we don't do everything in this fullness. So we're talking about the fullness of him is that we utilize this at the fullness, not partially, but fullness. I'm not saying we're not doing it because we are your Christians and we all is doing the things that God tells us to do. But there's more we can do. In the kingdom is always space. God always leaves a lot of space for us to grow. And we need to grow constantly. We receive the word every Sunday, every week. We read the Bible. We hear the Christians, them, the brothers and sisters. And we need to start moving on to telling people about what God has done for you. Oh, his son died for you. And he's dying for them also. And that all the things them that God promises will come to pass. But we are sure of that. We know that that will take place. And that's the assurance I'm talking about today. And it says, based on the foundation of repentance. You see, we go through that cycle of life. That's things, something don't work out the right way, and our life is not spinning the way that it's supposed to go. And sometimes it's just that the enemy, right, just waiting for any opportunity to use any situation that he can do to change that course. So we don't receive that word. We don't utilize that word as fullness as it's supposed to be. So that assurance, that insurance, what it is, a lifetime insurance, guaranteed life eternity for us, will never, never pass. Now nobody can change that. That stays stable forever. Once God said, if he gave his only begotten son, right, that we will be assured that anything that you want, you have it. And the most important thing is the eternal life. And we have guarantee on that. And that's what we can base on. So if we can base on that, that is what we have to make sure that all our assurance of our life and all the things that God says, it will come to pass. The word assurance is defined in dictionary, which I took a little time to go through the dictionary to check it out, to see exactly is what you have to say. And it says here, it defines the assurance of freedom from doubt. The word assurance is freedom from doubt. Firm of mind. Your mind has to be firm. You're determined. You receive the word of God. You accept him. You know that he will give you everything that he says. So you sure. So firm. Firm of your mind that set up that God will do what he said he will do when he already offered me eternal life. So I already have it. And that's all we are, Christian, acknowledge it. And we know. We should have confidence. That's the word, say confidence. It's your mind. Confidence. So whenever who asks you who you are in Christ, I'm the Son of God. Because you know that. And you act and you live by that way because God said. And what God says with me and with God, no one can change it. So if he says so, that stays that way. It's done. It's finished. It's done. So that assurance is telling us that we will be secure and we have confidence to make sure or certain. So we are sure. We have that insurance that everlasting life is given to us. You see? So since we have everlasting life and we have that assurance in that, there's certain things that we need to do to maintain that. Because we can't change that. You're just going to maintain it, live and enjoy the blessing of that, that God already promised to us. It's also defined as a benefit, a pledge, a guarantee, a state of being sure of certain security. So, let me see if we get this right now. God permit and give his son, right, the opportunity to pay for our sins, and we will reap and enjoy that benefit forever. So he gave his only begotten son so that we have freedom. And worth it and have eternal life. So if he did that with his son, there's nothing else he wouldn't do for us. It's done. As the scripture said, it says, he that spared his own son, but deliver him up from us all, or shall he be not him also freely give us all things? So we got all things. So this is something that you have to acknowledge, and it says that you have to have confidence, right? And you're certain that it's true because God says so. He says so. Right? So that's the definition of it. But it says it's based and upon the foundation of repentance. Now, repentance. I mean, we brothers and sisters, we know that without Jesus, we cannot make it here on earth. So, whenever we do something that is not godly, let us acknowledge that, then we have a right to repent and put it on the cross, to give it to God, Jesus Christ, and everything is back to normal. But you got to repent. You got to repent. It says based on repentance. So, what is repentance? I was looking through as I was going through. It says here, it's the first word of the gospel of Jesus Christ that he preached. Repent. Matthew chapter 4, verse 17. Pick it up. Let us make sure we go through this together. It's not what we do, but the word of God will take control and he take control of this service doing his will. His will has always been taken care of regardless of what we want and what we're doing. Matthew chapter 4, verse 17 says, amen, right? From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. That's the first word he came up. First gospel word, repent. So he knew that we would need to do so. He already have everything said. You know, you're going to eat the food, you set the table, you put the knife, the fork, the food. This is going to take place. So he prepared the table for us. So the scripture says, so when he prays, he said, prepare the table in the midst of my enemy. The table is already prepared. We are his children, and it's prepared. He said, repent. So, it is the first word of the gospel. The gospel is rich, and through the gospel, we are here today. Otherwise, we wouldn't be here. The gospel was preached, and we heard, and we believe, and we accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And through that, we are here today. We accept him. Just a little sidestep. You know, as I was going through this, there's a lot of little things, you know, you're reading and you're looking through this. There's a lot of things comes to your mind and you see a lot of stuff. And I was reading and I see something here says, what about religion without the Holy Spirit? What about Christian without Christ? What about forgiveness without repentance? What about salvation without regeneration? What about politics without God? Heaven without hell? You see, these things, them, they all go together. There's no way we can separate them. These are made together. It's like a coin that you have a coin and you try to cut the piece and try to cut it in half. You always have a head and a tail of it, but it's there. Don't care what you do, they are there together. And it must be there. So if you have you repent and don't forgive, there's no repentance. Well then, let us see. Your repentance is that you forgive. And if you forgive, then you repent, right? You do that. But repentance has a couple things, and I won't touch on this too much today. But repentance, it has what we call the root and the fruit. A lot of times we repent, but it's just outwards. It's not from inside. We need to do these things then. And these are things that we just touch on. I'm not saying that we don't do this. I say we do it. We say faith come by what? Hearing the word of God. So if we continue hearing these things, we start practicing them more. We hear a lot of things outside here, and we do them too and practice some of them. Amen. Mm-hmm. Yes, they're there. It happened. So we're going to talk this year in church, and we're going to share the word of God in church so we can hear these things and do them. Because God wants us to do his will. So repentance is where the assurance is based on. So the more you repent and things that you're doing, that you walk away, you stay away a little bit from Christ, then the assurance is more, you feel yourself. You see that assurance is there. You see, when God gave you, and his son dies, not his son getting dead, you know, he's dead already. And he will come back to life. It's the action is already done. So your assurance is already done to God. It's all a part of us that we walk and not accepting that sometime and walking, not firm in the things that we're doing in Christ, not firm in the things of God, not doing the things then believing that we are the children of God. It's not that we're going to be, we are the children of God. So we have to walk in that firmness. It's what we said, the confidence, the firm of mind. So when we do these things, then we assure ourselves that those things that God said will come to pass. You see, it's done, but we don't acknowledge it, we don't use it, then those things, it's not no whole in our life. It don't make a lot of, you see, out there, in that word, they got a word called insurance. And it insure for dead people. God insure you for life. For everlasting. It's not that you're going to have life today and then we insure you that you're going to be in a casket or whatever it is they do because they do their stuff. God is God of life. So if that is what we are, the Son of God, then we are living and we will live forever. So this is what it is all about. So that assurance is based on that repentance. So when you forgive, remember we just a little sidestep that we take there, tell us that there's no repentance without forgiveness, then you fully do it from inside. And then when you do that, make sure that when you turn back to God, like repentance means that you didn't turn back to God, you already walk or you sidestep, that you do it godly. You see what I'm saying? And when you take that out and you repent from inside and you forgive, hold it there, forget it and move on. Because God has more than you can ever imagine to bless you with. He said he will do all things. The word all, as I understand, and maybe you may understand it too, because we are Christian, you and me, and we are all the same right here, right? Serving the same God, it means everything. All. Not some, not partial, all. So, if God can bless us with all. And then the second word in the scriptures, if you read, and we can go to Mark chapter 1, verse 15. You see, we're checking up on what God has done through Jesus Christ and what Jesus Christ has done with us when he came and heard and he walked the face of this earth with us. He blessed us so much. Scripture says this, if he could write all the things that he did, we need a lot of books. The books would cover the whole earth. So so much has been done, but we get some, you know, something that will help us navigate and maintain yourself here until when he come back. It's like a, you know, I feed you and prepare you so you'll be here so when I come back. And you'll be here. Mark chapter 1 verse 15 says, amen? It says, and saying the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. That's faith. So we gotta repent and we have to have faith towards God. You see there? You see, for the assurance to come in place and to be active daily in our life, every minute, these things need to be done. It can be done and we do it. I know we Christians do it. And I pray to you because it says to those that receive the word of God is called saints. So all the saints here today, that's what we do. We need to do it. And I say in fullness, it says here, the way the assurance works is that it works regardless of we acknowledge it or not. So God not depending on you, what you do is what we can make it work. You remember that? It's we ourselves acknowledge what God has done for us. It's already done. You see? And we need to get to that fullness of it. It says the second word, faith is the second word but it's a faith towards God. When you get that, it's the second word of the gospel. So Jesus Christ came and preached two words about the gospel. There's a lot in that gospel. It's powerful. So the gospel is what we receive. So if we receive that, we receive the assurance. Okay, Jesus Christ brought something. He negotiated, as Pastor said, it's like that. He brought a negotiation. You repent, right? And you have faith in me. Then you can enjoy the blessing that I've already given to you. It's already in you, what I said, right? It's already given to you. Hebrews chapter 6, verse 1 and 2. Let's move a little faster, because the time is like you're not waiting on me. It's moving. You know, I so much I want to cover today, but hey, God is good. He will make I cover what he wants me to cover. It's not what I want to do. So let him tell his way here. Hebrews chapter 6, and we pick it up at verse 1 and 2. And it says, therefore having, everybody there, we got it, right? Yeah. Therefore leaving this principle of the doctrine of Christ, let us go on into the perfection, not laying again the foundation of repentance from dead works and faith towards God. Faith towards God. You got that, right? It's faith towards God. Of the doctrine of baptism and of laying of the hands and of resurrection of the dead and of the eternal judgment.